Hello friends, welcome to my channel. In this video we will learn about the coating inspector program which is conducted by MES. So basically the full form of MES is National Association of Corrosion Engineers, and the certification which they provide is MES CIP level 1 or MES CIP level 2 or MES CIP level 3. So this is the full name of the certification for coating inspector. So we have understood the full form of MES. Now CIP means, or the full form of CIP is coating inspector program. So this is how this name comes from, MES CIP level 1, level 2 or level 3. So in this video we'll learn about the MES coating inspector program, that is how many levels are there, what is the eligibility of MES coating inspector program, what is the fees. And the main thing is the difference between MES and BGAS program. So this is one of the most important point which we'll learn in this video. And finally, we'll learn about the job opportunity. Means after getting a MES certification, coating inspector certification, what are the prospects for job? So these are the things which we'll learn in this video. Now, before starting this video, I would request you to please join my channel. See here, you will see a join button under the video, and by clicking the join button, you can become a member of my channel. So the joining fees is very low; it is around 159 rupees. So you can join my channel, and after joining the channel, you will get access to some member exclusive videos. See friends, I'll make some videos on certification courses, exclusively on certification courses for members only. These courses are C-Sweep, MES, BGAS, API and NDT level 3. So these courses will be available for the members only. Secondly, you can attend the live seminar or sessions which I conduct on regular basis. And in this live session, you can ask your questions related to career, job or any other technical query. So I'll be happy to answer your question in the live session. And finally, you'll get a priority reply to your comments. So these are the benefits which you can avail by becoming a member of my channel. Now friends, let's start the levels. What are the levels in MES coating inspector program? So there are three levels in coating inspector program. First one is MES level 1. You have to start with MES level 1, then MES level 2, and then MES level 3. So the MES level 3 is the final level or the senior most level, and MES level 1 is the starting of the coating inspector program. So you can get level 1, then you can become level 2, and then you can become level 3. So three levels are there in MES painting inspector or coating inspector program. So what is the eligibility? So friends, for MES CIP level 1, there is no formal requirement of any experience, and there is no formal requirement of any education, but it is expected that you must have a minimum educational qualification of high school. In fact, if you are not high school pass, then also you are eligible for MES CIP level 1. Means there is literally saying there is no any requirement. Anybody can join this program. Anybody with any experience, fresher, any educational qualification, even without any educational qualification, you can do MES level 1. I hope it is clear to you. Now the course fee. See, MES level, the course fees for MES level 1 is approximately 2,20,000. So, and for level 2 also, the course fees is almost similar. See, for MES level 1, the course fees is around 2,20,000, and for MES level 2 again, you have to pay something around 2,17,000. So this is almost 2,20,000 only. So this is about the course fees. This figure are approximate only. You have to contact any authorized training center for the final fees. But these are the approximate and almost similar fees is there in. So normally the tuition centers or the authorized training centers used to give 5 days lecture and 1 practical exam with coffee breaks and lunches. So they provide coffee breaks and lunches within these fields only, and they give 5 days practical and exam in this fees only. And they also provide one set of course material, and the examination certification by NEST is also covered in this fees only. So within 2 lakh 20,000 you can avail these benefits. Now in NEST level 1, for NEST level 1 particularly there are 25 chapters. So there are 25 chapters, but here I have written the highlighted topics which are contained in those 25 chapters. So the topics which you study in NEST level 1 is corrosion control, coating introduction, curing mechanisms, role of the inspector, environmental test instruments, inspection procedures, non-destructive test instruments, coating specifications, documentation, surface preparation methods, application procedures, and coating failures. So these are the main topics which you learn during your NEST level 1 course. Now finally, our comparison, that NEST versus BGS, which one is best or which one you should do. So there is not any specific answer that NEST is best or BGS is best. However, we can do some comparison. Like our first comparison is based on the fees. So NEST is very costly. Normally you need to do NEST level 1 and level 2 both for a good job. So for level 1 and level 2 combined you will have to pay something like 4,40,000. You will have to pay 4,40,000 for level 1 and level 2. Whereas BGS is very cheap if you compare NEST. So it is less costly. For grade 2 you need to pay only 1,06,000 rupees. This is the concessional fees, means after COVID-19 pandemic the TWI has reduced the BGS fees, and now it is 1,06,000. Earlier it was 1,33,000, and in BGS only one grade, that is grade 2, is enough. Whereas in NEST you will have to do the level 1 and level 2 for a good job, but grade 2 in BGS is enough. See, there are two grades in BGS, grade 2 and grade 1. So the starting grade is grade 2 and the senior most is grade 1. So with grade 2 only, that is enough only in the industry. Now chances of getting job. So with NEST level 1 and level 2, you have a chances of getting job very high. Means with NEST certification, there are very high chances that you will get a job. But it is not guaranteed. Nobody can guarantee that after getting this certificate you will get a good job. But it is always expected that a NEST certificate holder will get a good job. So this is highly expected, that a NEST certified person will surely get a job, but it is not guaranteed. Whereas in BGS this chance of getting job is moderate. So here the chance of getting job is high, but with BGS the chance of getting job is moderate. It means it is low to moderate. Now if we compare salary, so a NEST certified person gets very high salary, whereas a BGS certified person get moderate to high salary, but the NEST certified level person will get very high salary. So here the NEST wins. Now fourth one is very important in industries. See, NEST is more reputed than BGS, and this is a truth. In the industries, the NEST certified persons are seen with a good reputation, whereas BGS is less reputed if you compare with NEST. So BGS is less reputed as compared with NEST. NEST is also considered a practical certification course, because more practical is done here. That's why in industries give NEST a good reputation. But renewal is with every 3 year you will have to go for a renewal. Means there is a 3 year and 6 year renewal program, whereas in BGS you will have to renew your certificate in 5 year and then 10 year. So here this is again a costly affair. Within 3 years you will have to renew your certificate. So these are the, you know, main differences. And one more is there, that American based companies always prefer a NES certified professional. American based companies and oil and gas companies, they prefer NES certified personnel, whereas the European countries prefers any of the certificate. Means European companies may prefer NES and may or BGS both. So if we see and if we conclude from these differences, that the cost is very high for NES, but chances of getting job and the salary is very high. So if you have money, if you have 4,40,000 rupees money, then you should go for NES instead of BGS. But if you don't have 4,40,000, then you should opt for BGS. Now, first question which you may ask is it very hard? So my answer is no. Both NES and BGS, both are not very hard. With correct strategy and dedication, you can clear the exam. So it is not very hard. With correct strategy, see, 25 chapters are there in level 1 only. So for 25 chapters, you need to give your time, you need to give your dedication level. So your time and dedication level is important. If you will give time, you will definitely crack NES CIP level 1 and level 2. Job opportunity. So as I mentioned in the C-suite versus BGS slide itself, that chances of getting job is very high. So that is, I have written here, that chances is very high but not guaranteed. See, job is not guaranteed with any of the certification course, either it is BGS, either NES or API or CSIP. So job is not guaranteed, but we can see the probability. So probability or chances of getting a job is very high if with NES. So this is a reason you can choose this topic. But in NES, you need to do, you know, both CIP level 1 and level 2 if you want to do a very good job. Now, shall I attend the NES CIP level 1 and level 2 exam? Now that if after all differentiation and all the concept, if a question arises in your mind that shall I attend, so I'll give my personal opinion. And my personal opinion is that if you have money, enough money in your saving account, then you should definitely do NES CIP level 1 and level 2. But if you don't have money, then I will not recommend you to borrow loan and do this course, because during the recent times or during the recent pandemic times, there are lots of instability and uncertainty. So with this instability and uncertainty, please don't take loan and do this course. Please don't do that. So if you have money in your saving account, then you should definitely do these courses. But if you don't have money, then I will not, or I will never advise anyone to borrow loan to attend this program. So I hope this is clear to you. Now finally, about me. Friends, my name is Sandeep Anand, and basically I am a mechanical engineer, and I am having 14 years of work experience in different fields and different sectors, and my hobby is sharing knowledge. So I used to share my knowledge with the help of my website www.weldingandentry.com and with the help of my YouTube channel. So this is about me, and one disclosure from my side is that I have not done either NES or BGS, any of the certification courses. So friends, I hope you like this video, you would have liked this video, and this video will help you in your career growth. Thank you very much.